You know, when the iPad Pro 2020 first came out, there was really nothing like it. But now, the playing field is kind of even. We gotta talk about it. What's good, y'all? Tight Shirt Terry Warfield back in the building, and today the shirt is tight. I hope you're having a good day so far. If this is your first time here, a big fat welcome to you. And if you're part of the family, I want y'all to do something different. If you came back, drop a hashtag fam down in the comments so that I know you are here. So, iPad 2020 and 2021. Man, it's been a wild 2020 and shaping up to be a wild 2021 already. But the question is, with the new M1 Max out, with the iPad Air 4, and possibly a new iPad on the horizon within possibly the next 1 to 4 months, should you still grab the iPad 2020? So let me break this video down. The first thing I want to do is tell you what I love about this thing, what I hate about it after using it for probably about 6 months now. Also, with all of these new offerings, next thing I want to talk about the 2018 iPad Pro, because a lot of y'all still talk about that, the iPad 4, the M1 Max, and ultimately, if you should still cop this thing in 2021. So let's get into it. Okay, so what do I think about the iPad 2020 after using it for about 6 months? To be honest with y'all, this is one of my favorite gadgets that I own. I think my top three are my A7S 3 that I'm using right now, my Mavic Air 2, and the iPad Pro. Listen, I got the 11 inch. If you want to know why I got the 11 inch over the 12.9, I'll put the link up there in the description. That video is right there. But I love this thing, yo. Like, it's so hard to hate the iPad Pro because it's so good. Yeah, it's a little bit pricey, but you get best in class screen, you get best in class processing power. The cameras, I don't really too much use the cameras on the iPad, so I'm not really gonna talk about those. To me, that's not an advantage because I don't use them. But it's fast, it's lightweight, it's damn sexy. The screen is amazing. It's like, I legit use this thing more than my MacBook Pro. Now, is it a replacement for me for my MacBook Pro? No, and I also made a video about that, which I'll put up there. Don't leave off this video to go watch them two videos. You can watch them after. But it's not a replacement, at least for me. It doesn't do enough things that I need it to do, such as like live streaming, which we'll talk about in 1 second. It doesn't do live streaming. It doesn't do true multitasking. And it doesn't have a true file management system like you get with like a MacBook or a Windows machine. So with that being said, for me, it's not the replacement for the MacBook Pro. However, I do find myself using it way more than the MacBook Pro because it's just so lightweight. It's so easy to grab this thing, shoot upstairs, work on some photos, or work on a video on LumaFusion, or, you know, whatever you want to do on an iPad Pro, like, it's got you covered. The only things I guess don't like about it is I wish that it had Thunderbolt 3, which we'll probably see that and the next iPad Pro. But one thing that really irks me is the freaking camera placement. When I got the tablet in landscape mode, I hate that my hand covers the camera, and then I gotta like shift all the way to this hand just to get the freaking thing to unlock. I wish it had Face ID and a fingerprint sensor like the iPad Air 4, but you know, we can't get everything. Maybe with the new one coming out. So I really think that this thing is like a whole package, even in 2021. Still legit, probably the best tablet that you can get out there. Now, what about the iPad Air 4, right? Because the iPad Air 4 came out a few months after the iPad Pro, and it's essentially like an iPad Pro, just scaled back a little bit. So I will say this, yo, unless you are a serious, and I mean serious, creator or professional or student or whatever, and you need the 120 hertz that the iPad Pro offers over the iPad Air, you need the LiDAR and all of that stuff out the camera from the iPad Pro over the iPad Air. You want 6 gigabytes of RAM versus the 4 gigabytes of RAM in the iPad Air 4 and more minimum storage, then I would say it's probably better to save yourself a few $100s and get the iPad Air 4. Because for 95% of people, I would say that the iPad Air 4 is a better value than the iPad Pro. Now, again, if you want the 120 hertz, you need that LiDAR, you need that better camera, you want the more RAM, you want all that stuff, then yes, go for the iPad Pro. But for most people, it's not worth the extra cost. Even if you get the iPad Air 4 in base configuration and you get 256 gigabytes of storage, you still come in cheaper than a iPad Pro in base configuration. Now, I'm gonna also say this, I don't have like an Apple keyboard and all that stuff. I ain't got money for that. So I can't speak on like the experience with one of the keyboards because I don't use them. I don't like adding bulk to the iPad. I like it to be small. I like it to be lightweight and powerful. Now, the 2018 iPad Pro, a lot of y'all also bring up. I wouldn't buy that in 2021 because there's really no need for it, right? If you get an iPad Pro 2018, you're still gonna pay probably $500 for it. You could get the iPad Air 4 for around that same price and get a new iPad with a new warranty and all of that stuff. So I wouldn't recommend getting a 2018 unless you get a crazy deal on it for like $250 or $300. I would steer you towards the iPad Air 4 or the 2020 iPad Pro. Now, I'm not going to talk about the iPad 8th generation because we're talking about the pro level devices that they offer. But I really love how Apple like has all of the different levels covered. But anyways, before we move forward, if you're liking this video so far, be sure to drop a like on the video. That thumb helps this video out so much. And also, if you have not subscribed, if you like this, do it now. Lastly, before we move forward, a lot of y'all always ask me about the music. Terry, what music are you using in your videos? Yo, it's from Epidemic Sound. I got a free 30-day trial in the description if you want to check it out. And I will also put a listing of all of the songs used in the description. If you don't like it, you can cancel after 30 days. Everything you used in 30 days, within that 30 days, I should say, is covered. Now, let's talk about the M1 Max, right? I have not used them, but I know a lot of my creator friends have them. And what they say is the M1 Max take away the processing advantage of the iPad Pro, because that's what we typically love about A chips, A14, A12, etc., is they are so freaking efficient and powerful, right? Well, the M1 Max don't have that problem where they have Intel chips anymore. They have Apple chips in them. So they're mad powerful, mad quick, mad energy efficient. Should you get one of those instead of an iPad Pro? That's a good question, because the base model MacBook Air with the M1 chip in it, I think is right around $1,000. By the time you get an iPad Pro and you add on a keyboard, you add on a Apple Pencil, which you can't have an iPad Pro without one of these, you up there in MacBook Air, MacBook Pro territory. I'm getting hot and I'm sweating. Or should you spring for one of the new MacBooks? I would say you need to think about your forward trajectory, right? If this is all you need and you don't need anything more, then maybe an iPad is for you. But if you think that, yo, I'm gonna get it to serious video editing and I might wanna switch to Final Cut or Premiere, I might wanna switch to DaVinci, I might wanna start typing a whole lot more and I don't wanna have to finagle with this keyboard and all of that stuff, I'ma always say the MacBook is the better option because it has a full operating system, it has a full file management system, it has plenty of in and out ports so you can connect live streaming cameras, microphones, all of that stuff, which you can't do on the iPad Pro for the same cost. So I really think, like, if you are okay with not having the touch experience, which is huge by the way, then I will probably say the better idea, if you got $1,000 to spend, would be probably the MacBook Air M1, because there's just so much more value for the money. Right now, last thing we need to talk about. Although, again, I love this thing, and I still think if you want an iPad, this is the way to go in 2021. Well, Terry, what about the new iPad Pro that Apple's gonna announce soon? Well, first of all, we don't officially know that it's being announced in March, which is next month at the time of this video being filmed. However, if it does come out next month, would you be salty if you just bought an iPad Pro? That's the question. If you bought the 2020 generation iPad Pro and Apple come out the cut like, yo, we got these 2021 iPad Pros and they got mini LED, they got Thunderbolt 3, they got better cameras and probably the same processor, probably bumped up a little bit from the iPad Air 4, would you be salty? And I think that's a question you really gotta ask yourself. The other thing I forgot to mention is the advantage of the iPad Pro over the iPad Air 4, you can get the iPad Pro in 12.9 inch configuration. With the iPad Air 4, you can only get the 10.9 inch. So I forgot to throw that in there. I don't know if it's coming, I don't know the specs. There's rumors and all of that stuff, but you know what, Apple, we gotta wait till we hear about it before I could trust rumors and stuff like that. But ultimately, at the end of the day, I think in 2021, the iPad Pro, contrary to what everybody says, I think the iPad Pro 2020 is still a great freaking buy in the year 2021. And if one comes out that's better next month, I mean, the good thing about Apple products is you could just sell it and recoup most of your money. But I really like the iPad Pro, like, this thing is so good. I don't even think if they came out with the next edition, if this is what you could get right now, I'm a big advocate of what you could get right now, what makes you happy, get it now. I don't think you'll be upset at all because this thing is so freaking good. But anyways, I'm done ranting, man. I love this iPad Pro for freaking everything. It's one of my favorite devices ever made. But I would love to know what y'all think in the comments. So let me know if you got an iPad, which one you have. If you're thinking about it, are you about to cop now? Are you getting an iPad Air 4, maybe an M1 MacBook? Or if you're thinking about copping the 2020 and 2021, or are you gonna wait? I would love to know what y'all think. I'm gonna be down in the comment section kicking it with y'all. So till next time, I am out of here. That's all I got. Peace and chicken grease, Terry Warfield. Peace.